Hello, good morning students. Today this is our social science lecture, right? In that we learn the revision. Now we are doing the revision of the chapter 4, 5 and 6. So everyone pay attention and open your book. Page number 19 in that chapter 4. So what is the name of the chapter 4? That is how the traders became a ruler. Traders become ruler. Why here given that traders become ruler? Now you know that the British, who is the traders? Here the Britishers is the traders. Right. Who is Britishers are traders? After a long time, what they do? They are become a ruler. Why they become a ruler? Because the Britisher came to India. Britishers came to India in the point of the trade. Then what they do? They became ruler. Why? Because after that they introduce one by one, they introduce the policy of the traders, and also they have started the war, and then they take that step, right? So they became the ruler. So in the first one, that is Wellesley's policy of expansion. So first, that is first topic of this unit, Wellesley's policy of expansion. So which policy the Wellesley introduced? Which policy the Wellesley introduced? In that, the Wellesley came to the India to become a general government, general governor. Governor general. Wellesley's policy of expansion, in that who became the governor general of India? That is a Wellesley's. And then why they exist? And here the cutthroat competition. Cutthroat competition. Why there is a cutthroat competition? Because there are many traders are there. So in between them, there are competition. So we can say that this is the cutthroat competition. Then between the cutthroat competition exists between the which country? England and France. England and France. In this two country, or between two countries, there are the cutthroat competition. Hear this, that British rule in India becoming powerful. British rule in India become a powerful. Why they become a powerful? Because the Governor General of India, that is a Wellesley, and they introduced, Wellesley introduced which system? Subsidiary alliance system. Have you remember or not? Subsidiary alliance system. Subsidiary alliance system introduced by the Wellesley. In that, what was in that subsidiary alliance system? The state or the town compulsory accept this system. Otherwise, they take that step. So here, see that as per the scheme, any princely states that except the alliance had to keep and maintain the army. Why they introduced this system? To maintain the British army. Then, as well as keep a British representative in a royal court and British representative in a royal court, that also to maintain. For that, they had introduced this system, subsidiary alliance system. Then, the princely state were not allowed to utilize the army at their own will. Then this system might feel secure. This system is looking like a good at the stage of the beginning, but at the last it becomes a very complicated. So the Indian state had become the victims of the subsidiary alliance war. Remember this, who victims of this subsidiary alliance system? So here the name of the victims. It may ask in one mark or MCQ question. So underline it also. That is Hyderabad, then Mysore, then Ayodhya, Jodhpur, Gaikwad, of Baroda or Vadodara. Peshwas of Pune. Then Sindhis of the Gwalior. To maintain the British army, they were announced or introduced a subsidiary alliance system. And the victim of the subsidiary alliance system is the Hyderabad, Mysore, Ayodhya, Jodhpur, Gaikwad of Vadodara, Peshwas of Pune, Sindhis of the Gwalior. They are the victims. This stands, or we can say that these towns are the victims of the subsidiary alliance system. Then, who was the first victim of this system? That is Nizam of the Hyderabad was the first victim. If there is an MCQ, who was the first victim? First victim of the subsidiary alliance system. So your answer is Nizam of Hyderabad. Nizam of Hyderabad, that is the first victim of the subsidiary alliance system. Understand? Then in Mysore and Ayodhya. First Hyderabad, then Mysore and the Ayodhya, then Tanjore and Karnataka met with the same. They also the part of the subsidiary alliance system. The British might the Marathas fight amongst themselves and consequently might them accept the subsidiary alliance system. the Maratha fight against among themselves. In between the Maratha and Maratha, among the Maratha, there were a fight. Right? Why? Because of this system. To accept this system, some Maratha say to accept the subsidiary alliance system, and some Maratha denied about this system or ignored this system, or we can say that they refused. So because of this system, among the Maratha there was a fight, right? Or we can say that there was a dispute. Then the losses incurred by Nizam in his fight of the Maratha. Who incurred the losses? Maratha, right? Nizam of the Maratha, they incurred the losses. He was the first to accept this alliance. Nizam of the Maratha, that was the first to accept the subsidiary alliance system. So here, after that, he was the first to accept this system. Then Tipu Sultan of Mysore refused to do so. But after the British victory in the fourth angle of Mysore war, Mysore was forced to become a subsidiary state. Maratha chief fought among themselves. And here, now there is in the Maratha, there was the death of Nana Fadnavis. The death of Nana Fadnavis. After the death of Nana Fadnavis, then what happened? Then one all Maratha. After that, the death of Nana Fadnavis, that was one rule, that is divide and rule. As in the divide and rule policy introduced. Divide and rule policy introduced. Where this policy was introduced? After the death of Nana Fadnavis, the policy of divide and rule introduced. Understand? Within the span of 7 years, Wellesley expanded the company rule and made the British supreme power. Then, after the span of the 7 years, Wellesley expand their trade, then the British become a supreme power. British became a supreme power. British become a supreme power. After the death of the Nana Fadnavis, then what happened? Then there is a divide and rule. And the benefit of the divide and rule policy, Wellesley expand the trade. And within the span of the 7 years, the British became the superpower. In the trade, British became the superpower. Understand this? That is the Wellesley's policy of the expansion. Understand this? Now, if you have to write, if you don't write, then you can write. And if you already have written, this is a revision. So, if you don't write, then it is okay. Clear? Now, moving further to our second topic. Thank you. Expansion in the British rule in India. Next topic, that is expansion of the British rule in India. Now, first we understand that is Wellesley's policy. After the successful of the Wellesley's policy, there is an expansion of the British rule in India. So, after the finalizing of the subsidiary alliance system, the Mysore and the Nizam of the Hyderabad and Maratha, right, British moved toward the, after the successful of this state, then Britishers moved to the northern side. So in the northern side, they have to enter. In the northern side, they have entered and the friendly relation with the Nepal. That is the threat of the Britishers from the Nepal. The main threat of the Britishers from the Nepal. Why? Because of the Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Right? And Maharaja Ranjit Singh helped them to win the battle with the Abkhaz. So here the British have a main threat from the Nepal. So who is the king of the Nepal at that time? At that time there was a Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Maharaja Ranjit Singh. At that time, the king of the Nepal, that is Maharaja Ranjit Singh. And because the British have the threat from the Maharaja Ranjit Singh, so Britishers begin the friendly relation with the and Maharaja Ranjit Singh. So Maharaja Ranjit Singh helped the Britisher to fought against the Abkhaz in the battle of Abkhaz. Who had the Britisher? That is Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Then established their rule in after the born in the Abkhaz. They established their rule in the Abkhaz also. Now they become the ruler in the Abkhaz. The Sikh kingdom, or we can say that is Sindh. The rule in the rules in the Sindh. Then there is a given, the Sikh kingdom, which was a very powerful kingdom, but they do not do so long as Maharaja was alive. Then Sindh kingdom, then Sikh kingdom, in that Maharaja Ranjit Singh. So if the Maharaja was alive, at that time, British cannot do anything with the Sikh kingdom. But after the death of the Sikh kingdom, who take the step? That is the Britishers. So they kept a friendly relation. So the Maharaja Ranjit Singh is a powerful kingdom. Or the Sikh kingdom is a powerful kingdom. So they cannot do so. So they cannot take this step. But at the time of the Maharaja was alive, then Maharaja, why they cannot do so? Because Ranjit Singh was a strong ruler with the help of European officer for the protection of his state. or the Sikh kingdom, that is Punjab, that is also taken by the Britishers after the death of the Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Clear this expansion of the British rule in India, how they annexed, how they taken that state. Clear? Annex the all these states after one by one. Fought with the state and the Britishers tank their state. After the battle, Britishers tank their state. Understand this? Then dead houses. This is the Wellesley's policy. Now in the next topic, there is a dead houses policy. Now there is a dead houses.
Then railway
first railway line. First railway line is started in the year 1853 CE, right? And the first railway line was started between the Mumbai and Thane. Mumbai and Thane, the first railway line, and started in the year 1853 CE. Remember this. Then the Dalhousie also passed the law, that is law to ban child marriage and advocated widow remarriage. Here the Dalhousie banned child marriage. Dalhousie passed the law to ban a child marriage and widow remarriage and advocated widow remarriage. So if any ladies husband was died in the war or any something anywhere or any else matter, then if they have the ladies have the right to do a again marriage, that is called the widow remarriage. Okay, clear? And the English education also spread during the Dalhousie's policy. English education. Also spread during the tenure of the Dalhousie. And that is the first free university. Remember this, first free university in India was established in the Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Clear? And the year 1857 CE, first university was established in Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Understand this? Then dissatisfaction of people. The next topic, that is dissatisfaction of the people. After the policy of the subsidiary alliance, Dalhousie's policy of annexing suited the whole nation terrible. After the introduction of this law and this policy, that is terrible. This policy dissatisfied the people. So here, now the among the people there were the dissatisfaction regarding the Dalhousie's. So here, in addition to that, reforms made by Dalhousie's added, that is fuel to fire, and the Kranti and Mangal Pandey in this movie, that is given that all policy of the Britishers and how the British become the ruler, that all things are given in this two movie. And also the orthodox people find that the British wanted to the telegraph and the Western education. And also after the announcement of this policy, that is the effect to the people. So here we do the revision of chapter 4. Clear this, understand, and still you have any doubt, then you can ask me in a group between the 8:45 to 9 p.m. Clear this? Okay, students, bye and take care.